Hello there, my name is Jake Roper, and you probably can't really see me right now. Let's throw a lens on that camera. Ah, there we go, look at that, let's just lock it into place. Ooh, much better. Now I want you to look deeply into my eyes. We're seeing each other through three lenses, four if you wear glasses. Now light is coming off of my eye, going through my glasses into the camera lens, and then out of your screen into the lens in your eye. And in fact, let me grab one. Most camera lenses have many pieces of glass stacked inside of them. So while we call this whole single piece a lens, it's actually made up of many different lenses bending light between the two of us. And we're gonna take a look with our eyeball lenses at some optical dongs, things that you can do online now, guys. Richtu's Ray Optics Simulator is a great way to visualize how light moves around when distorted by various surfaces. You can make beams, rays, and other light phenomena interact with various reflective and translucent surfaces. And you can change a whole bunch of factors, like the density of the beams and the shape of the reflective or transparent surfaces. So why then does light bend like that? Well, we'll get to that in a second, but let's first talk about why light can go through things at all. You can't see through me, or at least I hope you can't. So what makes glass so special? When a photon hits something opaque, like you or me, it either scatters away in random directions or it's absorbed by the material. Transparent materials, on the other hand, don't absorb light, but instead let it pass right through, and that's what a simple sheet of glass does. The science of why this happens is very cool and very complicated. 60 Symbols has a wonderful video on the topic. You can check it out right here. There's a link at the top of the description. But basically, when light hits an object, the energy in the photon is absorbed by the electrons in the object's atoms. With glass, however, the price of entry is a bit too high. So the atoms in the glass want more energy than visible light can provide. So the light just keeps on trucking. This applies to visible light, but not so much for UV light. You can check out my video from last year where we use predator vision. And it's all about UV cameras and ultraviolet lights and infrared. Anyway, it's really cool. Now, do you see this? This is a lentil, and the word lentil is where the word lens comes from. Lentils were never used to make lenses or anything, but they look a little bit similar as the basic lens shape. Legumes are a tasty treat. Anyway, lenses are really any curved glass bends the light that passes through it. Now, Jake, how does this work? Well, my inquisitive little turtle, great question. It takes advantage of two fundamental properties of light. The first is that light slows down in certain types of materials, be it air, water, or glass. And now you might be saying, I thought the speed of light was constant. Well, that's just the speed of light in a vacuum. Again, there's a lot of weird quantum stuff going on, but the important thing is that once light enters other mediums, it's forced to interact with the other atoms hanging around. Those interactions slow everything down. Now, the second property of light is that it's not just a particle, but it's also a wave, which means it fluctuates in three-dimensional space. Imagine a group of runners all running next to each other, tied together with ropes. If the group starts running through mud at an angle, one of them will be slowed down faster, and the others will have to change angles to stay parallel. That's essentially what's happening when light curves through a cup of water or a camera lens. And this allows us to do all sorts of crazy things to incoming light. You probably have zoomed into something with a camera before. If you have, you may have also seen these levels of magnification measured in millimeters. For example, this video is being shot on a 50 millimeter lens. That number measures the distance between the front of the lens and the back of the lens. It's called the focal length. And on this site, you can get an idea of what focal lengths look like in real life. You can mess with the actual zoom of the camera as well as the camera body that captures that image. And that seems pretty straightforward, right? Well, it's actually a very complex process to make sure that images stay sharp and consistent while changing magnification. And it involves many layers of glass of different shapes. So when you twist a zoom lens, you are actually physically moving the pieces of glass around inside. You can actually feel it when you do this. And some lenses actually stick out when you do that. Not this one, though. This moves an afocal zoom system, which is a few convex lenses which bend light inward, with a concave lens between them, which bends light outward. So as the light from the object you want to magnify comes in, it gets focused and then re-spread out to make the image appear bigger on the image sensor. And keep in mind that there are some types of lenses that don't zoom, and they're called prime lenses. Oh, and if your phone can zoom in, it's not the same process. That's just the camera enlarging the digital image rather than actually bending the light to make an object appear closer. It's the same thing we do in our videos where we punch in to make it look like it's a closer shot when it's really like this. Okay, so you can zoom in all you want, but going back to the beginning of this video, what about when everything is out of focus? Well, Michael just did a dong episode on how to use a pinhole to create a two-dimensional image, and a perfectly small pinhole will create a perfectly sharp image. As we make the opening bigger, we're going to end up with more blur. On a camera lens, the system that measures the amount of blur is determined by the size of the opening, also called the aperture or f-stop. And this website allows you to get an idea of how changing the f-stop changes the level of blur around the object that's in focus. So you might not be able to see it on this, but if I adjust the f-stop here, we'll do an insert shot where it's closer for you. Ooh, wow, wow. Now anyone who uses cameras regularly has noticed something strange when changing the aperture. As the f-stop increases, the aperture gets smaller. This seems a bit backwards, but that's because f-stop is a fraction. And this fraction, to be exact, right here. But wait, why go through all this math in glass when I just said a pinhole keeps everything perfectly sharp? Well, the simple fact is that pinholes are very, very small and they don't let in a lot of light. Going back to Michael's video for a second, you can see how an out-of-focus image comes from receiving light from multiple points on the image sensor from the same point on an object, and that's not very good. What lenses allow us to do is to take much more light in, bend it so that there is still a one-to-one relationship between a point on the object and a point on the sensor. Of course, that sensor can be anything, like your eyeball. Your eye has a very similar structure to a prime lens. It can't zoom in and out, but it's very good at focusing light onto the retina. Your cornea, lens and retina mimic a camera lens almost exactly, but instead of moving the lens back and forth like in a camera, it stretches and squeezes. Those with near or far sightedness have a problem with one or more of the mechanisms that should allow their eyes to focus, like the lens unable to change shape correctly or the cornea being warped in some way. So there's some info for you on lenses. I think lenses are so incredibly cool because, okay, little side note, this isn't maybe that interesting to you, but it is to me. When you buy a set of lenses, a lot of times they have to color match the glass because the glass can actually change the look or the color that you see of the image. So most times when you buy really nice lenses, the entire set of lenses is color matched. So if you switch from like a 14 millimeter to a 25 millimeter and so on and so forth, they all still look the same, even though the distance that it's showing is different. It might be close to the lens now, but the color will match. And that's important because, again, there are so many lenses in just one of these lenses. Anyway, I could go on forever about lenses. I love them. I think they are so, so neat and just so wonderful. Like, what a crazy invention. But that's for another time, maybe. You know what's for now? More dongs. Right down there, ones that we talked about. Playlist of dongs right over here. And as always, this isn't gonna work the way I want it to, but just imagine that you think, I think you know what I'm doing, but it's not gonna work. And as always, thanks for watching. You probably can't see my eye, but just imagine that you can, and how cool that would have been as an outro. But like everything in my life, it didn't work. Now Jack's just pulling focus somewhere. Where are you going, Jack? Where are you pulling that focus? Am I out of focus? Am I blurred now? Is the whole image blurry? Jack, you can speak. It's okay, Jack.